indeed for that manufacturing insight.
Thank you.
We're going to move on to aerospace, and here's a name that you should remember, and I urge you to, Zarya Serfontein, and that'll come clear in a minute. Zarya is looking at drag augmentation systems for space debris mitigation. I think I understand what that means. Now, the point about memory is, Zarya won made it to the semifinals of a short-term memory skills TV contest, TV game show in Ireland called Memorizer. Zarya, have I got that right, or am I making this up?
Yeah, no, that's correct.
Incredible. Okay, I want to find out more about your memory there, but you know the rules now. So when you see that countdown timer reach that that point at the top of the clock, please go ahead and tell us more about drag augmentation.
So even though we don't often think about them, satellites are an integral part of our everyday lives. Whether you're checking the weather forecast, tracking an Amazon delivery, or navigating a new city, you're depending on satellites. Right now, there are more than 2,600 man-made satellites orbiting Earth above us, and that number is growing rapidly. The space industry is increasingly commercialized, and satellites are cheaper to build and launch every year, making space more accessible to everyone, even university students. Tens of thousands of satellites are planned to be launched within the next decade, including mega constellations, which consist of individual small satellites, thousands of them, working together. Advancements in satellite technologies have helped us improve life here on Earth, but they've also contributed to an increasingly worrying issue, space debris. So satellites that are orbiting the Earth are traveling at about 8 kilometers a second. So to give some context to that, that's 10 times the speed of a bullet. With that much energy, even small constellations can have massive, even small collisions in space can have massive consequences. Debris from satellite collisions don't just fall back to Earth or burn up in the Earth's atmosphere, but continue orbiting the Earth, posing a serious potential threat for operating satellites. So what are we doing to fix this? Well, some companies in the space industry are working on active debris removal. So this is basically developing spacecraft that can remove debris from low Earth orbit. But this on its own is not enough. What we need to do is we need to make sure that future satellites are equipped with the tools that they need to remove themselves from orbit after their missions. One of the ways to achieve this is through drag sails, which you can see in the slide here. Basically, these sails are attached to the satellite before launch. They remain stowed throughout the lifetime of the satellite. And then once the satellite has completed its mission, the sail deploys, increasing both the area and the drag of the satellite and allowing it to re-enter and burn up in the atmosphere. At Grand Duke University, we've already developed and launched 3 of these drag sails. My thesis now looks at developing the next generation of the sail and trying to overcome the challenges we've had with the survivability of these sails in the harsh low Earth orbit environment. We have to protect our sails against a wide range of changeable temperatures, the vacuum of space, radiation, and debris and micrometeorite impacts. Many of the low Earth orbit satellites, which have been launched in recent years, are there to help us understand the impact of decades of reckless industrialization on our planet. We now have the chance to learn from our mistakes and proactively protect the space environment. These sails will be one of many potential methods of decluttering the space environment and ensuring that we're preserving space for the future. Thanks.
Zarya, thank you. 4 seconds remaining. That was very smooth. And I'm thinking of that Sandra Bullock film, Gravity. I do believe George Clooney was in it too. Possibly Tom Stevenson I saw in the background as well. So thank you so much for that. Wow, we're going to move on quickly now.